Hi everyone, I am Emmanuel Tom. Here I am going to explain how to calculate CO attainment and course attainment as part of our NBA accreditation purpose. So, you know that it is a somewhat difficult task. Here we have prepared designed one template in Excel sheet to calculate CO attainment. So, before we are starting the discussion about the calculation, some basics I'd like to discuss. In the beginning of course, the course facilitator defining some set of COs. What's the use of those COs? Actually, COs are the expectation of the facilitator that after his or her student completing that course should be able to do this level of task. So, in this network theory, I have defined four COs. Among that, two CO I defined here. CO1 is student should be able to solve DC and phasor circuit using KCL, KVL, mesh and nodal analysis. Those are my COs, CO1. Like that, CO2 related to graph theory. Then, in this CO, among these, like that, four COs are there. How many number of students able to attain those COs that we are going to evaluate? That's a difficult task. To evaluate that one, we are using assignment series, like the different methods. Actually, these assignment series are direct assessment methods. Then there is one indirect assessment method. In that one, we are taking the feedback from students. And the sum of all these direct and indirect assessment is the course attainment as well as course CO attainment as well as course attainment. So, how we can calculate this CO attainment for a series? Here I am going to explain the template with the help of one CAT question paper, that is series question paper. This question paper is based on K2 scheme. The format what we are following for Calicut scheme is different question paper pattern. That one you can understand later. After you are understanding K2 scheme, how it is working, it is easy to understand Calicut scheme. This CAT1 question paper is for, already I told you, network theory. And the question paper pattern is, part A contain 3 questions. Question number, you can see question number here. 1, 2, 3 questions, each of them carrying 4 marks. And part B contain 2 questions, 4 and 5. And each of them contain 8 mark. Students supposed to answer any one of the question. Means part A is compulsory and part B is contain or question. Then before this question number, there are two more columns are there. One is level and second one is CO. Already I told you, we are evaluating our students based on our COs. So our question should address our COs, then only we can evaluate our students. So my first question is, or for namesake, I'm taking my third question. What do you mean by incidence matrix? That is a topic I have taught in my class related to graph theory. And so automatically, since it is coming under graph theory, it will comes to CO2. Then it is just asking what you mean by incident matrix and what are the properties. So it's by hearting. So it is coming under level 1. Level means, according to Bloom's taxonomy, questions can be either in remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluate or create. The questions can be in any one of these 6 levels. If one student is directly answer by hunting, he or she is able to answer the question, it's a remembering. So the third question is remembering level. But the first question, that is related to KCL and KVL, but they have to understand whether it is conservation of charge or momentum. So it is coming under second level. You can read that question. It's asking match the list and justify your answer. So it is in second level. But third question is calculation, that based on KCL and KVL and other things. So it is somewhat applying. So which level it is coming among this one? It can be first level remembering, second level understanding, third level applying, like that is goes to up to create. These two columns it is essential to calculate CO attainment. Similarly for part B. Then the next condition we have to make sure, the already I told you in part A questions are compulsory. So it can be the first question can address CO1, second question can address CO2, like that each question can address different COs or same COs, it is not a problem. But when we are coming to OR questions, if the first question, here you can see the first, fourth and fifth questions are addressing CO1 itself. And the condition is, if fourth question is addressing CO1, then surely the fifth question also should address CO1. If fourth question is address CO2, the fifth question also should address CO2. Here one more option is there. Fourth question contain A and B. You can choose like this. Fourth question A address CO1. And fourth question B address CO2, then automatically fifth question also should the combination of CO1 and CO2, and the mark distribution also should be same. Means here I have given the 4A and 4B have equal weightage, but I can give 4A is 5 mark and 4B is 3 mark, and 4A is CO1 and 4B is CO2. Then in the fifth question, the same mark distribution, there should be questions related to CO1 and CO2, and the question related to CO1 should contain 5 mark, and question related to CO2 contain 3 mark. The same mark distribution you are supposed to follow. Otherwise, the calculation will be difficult. And logically, it is correct also. We are assessing evaluating our students, the same COs we are supposed to give in our question. Then after you are setting the question paper like this, this is the template what we are going to follow. This is CO attainment. So in this CO attainment, you can see it contain different sheets. Number of sheets are here. The first sheet is series 1 evaluation, then its assessment, series 2 evaluation, its assessment, then assignment 1 evaluation and its assessment, assignment 2 evaluation, its assessment, then indirect assessment, then final CO attainment. This much steps are there. So the first step we are going to see, that is assignment 1, the same format we are following in series 1 and series 2, series 1, series 2, assignment 1, assignment 2, all these things, same steps we are following. So if you are able to understand series 1, then it is easy to, you can just follow the same steps in series 2, assignment 1, assignment 2. So this is our template. In this template, you can see that it contain three parts. Means the first part, this blue color part, it contain the name and details of students. Second part, this here we are entering mark, then based on we are entering mark based on CO wise, then total CO mark is calculating here. Then at the lower part, based on the mark we have entered, the total CO the attainment calculation is happening at the bottom part for this series 1. So before you are entering marks to this template, you have to set some initial conditions. They are follows. First one, here you can enter the register number, name, all those things. Then, from the question paper, already we have seen part A and part B. So, similarly, same pattern we are following in our evaluation sheet also. Here, we have seen part A and part B. Same thing we are going to follow in our evaluation sheet. Here, part A is this one, part B is this one. Then, part A contains CO1. How many CO1? 1, 2. Each of them contain 4 mark. So, part A contains CO1, maximum 8 mark. Part B contain, and part A contain 1 CO2 question. So, 1 CO2 question. Question number 3 is CO2. Question number 1 is CO1. Question number 2 is CO1. Question number 3 is CO2. And it contain 4 marks. Okay. Then, part B. In part B, both are CO1. So, question number 4 and 5 are CO1. In question number 4, there is A and B. 4A and 4B, 5A and 5B. Both of them, all 4 addressing same CO, then it is not a problem. And the maximum mark we are taking from part B is 8 mark. Among that one, CO1 contains 8 mark itself, means CO2 contains 0 marks. This I already told you, the part A you can make in any format. For question number 1 is CO1, question number 2 is CO2, question number 3 is CO3, like that, any format you can design. But in part B, if 4A is contained, 4A is addressing CO1 and it contains 5 marks, and 4B is addressing CO2 and it contains 3 marks, then same format you have to follow for 5. 5A should address, if it 5A addressing CO2, it should contain 3 marks. Then automatically 5B should address CO1, it carries 5 marks. Then among this 4 and 5, one of them we will take here. Then automatically you have to write here CO1 carries 5 mark and CO2 carries 3 marks. So this is the initial step what you are supposed to do here. Then next one, on the bottom side also, here you can see course wise mark. So question 4 is contain 4 mark, question number 1 is contain 4 marks, question number 2 contain 4 marks, question number 3 contain 4 marks, like that. What is the marks? Then here, what is the level you have choose here? In this one, level 1, level 2, level 3. Like that, this level 1 means understanding. So my level 1 means remembering. My third question is related to level 1, remembering. Type R, capital letter R. Then, first question is related to understanding, that is level 2. So, automatically, first question, it is, we have to write U here, and it addressing CO1. Second question is related to CO1, and it is in the level 3. So, it is applying. So, we have given that one here. That also, you have to enter. Then the next remaining session, I will continue in the next video.